Welcome to this short video in which I'll show you how you will set up a model to read analog values. An analog value is entered in the board via this potentiometer. And by turning here I can adjust the voltage on this the middle pin, which is directed to the board again. And also some PWM signaling that you can create, which I'll show you here on this LED, assembly. First of all, some rules. This is the board, and as you can see, when you take it, I've placed the STM board on it, and it can only be positioned in one way. As you can see, this USB cable is going over the board. And if I would turn it around 180 degrees, then this would never fit over here, and I could never put the board properly on the the measuring board. So take care of this, that you position it properly in the right direction before connecting anything else. And when connecting everything, just first plug in your board itself, and when you've plugged in the board, then after that plug in your power cable, so that LED over there is lighting up, which shows you that you have 12 volt from the external adapter available. Okay, that is regarding the board and the connections. How to connect, you can find in your PDF showing the schematic diagram of the board itself, which with everything on it. We will explain that a little bit further during the lessons. So the only thing that you have to know now is that this is the inputs, where you have already did some MEC assignments, so K3, and here we have two possibilities to connect such an RGB display. And alongside that, we can mount two motors. So, how will you proceed to be able to read that value and put some PWM signal on it? First of all, of course, again, start your MATLAB and open your Simulink start project, which we saved last time. I've opened it already, start project, and as I said, first thing to do is always do a save as and save it under a new name, so that your start project is not corrupted anyhow. So let's do it my first app. There it is. Okay. First thing we'll do is create something to read the analog value, and for that we are opening the library browser, which we still, so there it is, and we have to select the STM32 library, and we have two analog digital converters, and we will take what you can see also is when I put the mouse on top of a block, the explanation which is in the block is being shown. Let's take this one. The other one is being used. This one is being used in assignment later on. Well, as you can see, it asks for a pin number, and the pin number that's connected from here until the board is pin 25 on the board, and as I explained earlier, that's number 1, 15, and 25 over there. So we'll type 20, come on, 25. The pin is connected. If I double click on it, you can see that the pin number is over there, and it will be sampled every TS time. Reading this, we can put a scope on it. Just put your click on the graphical area here somewhere and type scope, and it will give you a scope, number of ports. Well, let's just do one the first time, and you can resize it, whatever you want, and you can connect it. So this should be a simple program where we can read an analog value from the pot meter and it show it here in the scope. Just let's try it. And how did we did it? We could go via apps and then run on hardware board, or if we have the tab hardware already available, take that directly and say monitor and tune. It will take a while, of course. There it is. When it starts running, and I put the what is it here, the limits. And as you can see, it's basically flippering or going around between 6 to 6 and 6 to 8. And when I turn on it, yep, you see it going up and down, up and down. Let's just stop it for now. Scale it again. Come on. So there it is. And now we have some pretty normal scaling, because the value that we can be read is between 0 and 4096. 95 is the maximum value. And there are all kinds of options that you can try above here to set the scaling to fixed values. But you may figure out that yourself. I just want to show you something else. If you do not change your model here somehow, then we can restart the model as much as we want to and stop it as much as we want to. And for that, we go here on the hardware tab, take this prepare, and we say control panel, put it over there, and I'll show you this again. And what we can do now, because the software has not changed, we can connect to it as much as we want to. Show you here, and when it's connected, everything will the scope will be cleared, and the time will here start at 0, and it will say, okay, I'm waiting for something, and it's waiting for us to press start real-time code. So I will do that, start it, and from then that moment you can see that it's running. And when I turn a little bit here on the pot meter, it will of course do what I do with it. I can take everything, or can scale even everything that's available until now. Oh no, no, no! You see, with auto scaling, it can do some stupid things. So, and there it is. We have all the data that has been read between the start moment, 0 seconds, and the end, 29.04. So if we want to start again, we say connect. We can start, and we can stop over here, over there, or even over here. Doesn't matter. So as long as you don't change the model in one way or another, you can use this control panel to connect and start and stop and do your stuff. Okay. That's the first one. Second thing that I would like to add now is some PWM generation. And for that, we have for this board specifically, as you can see, it tells you something about the board that you can read on your own. And we drag it here. I'll press the space bar, so we have a little bit more here. And as you can see, we have 4 inputs, and every input will specify the duty cycle of the PWM signal lit up the LED or a motor. So as you can see here, we have a motor PWM, and that's one of the connections over there. And we have 3 LEDs here, which is the one 4 over here, and the other 4 is the other set. So we have a set of LEDs plus motor, and another set LEDs plus plus motor. And that's being defined by entering a number here. And as it says, it has to be, where it is, yeah, timer number should be 0 or 1. So timer 1 selects the one combination, and when you enter 2 here, it selects the second combination. And you can see in the schematic, which is for 1 and which is for 2. Also, you can define which one of these outputs, and also of course these inputs, are really being used. So you can say, I don't use the motor output, but I need, for instance, the LED outputs. And you do that by setting placing a one in the field over here, and you can specify the PWM frequency, which for instance I will now set at 1 hertz. Okay, and to be able to do something manually, I could, for instance, let's try this. The first LED will be controlled by that value, and I can constant type it here, type 100, and connect it, and copy paste, for instance, 0 for now for this one, and connect it also. So now I have a system. Zoom out a little bit, come on. So, where I don't use the PWM for the motor right now, as I specified here also, just I don't really have to connect anything. And I'm using 3 LEDs at a frequency of 1 hertz, where this will determine the duty cycle. Yeah, okay, let's save it and let's run it. See what's happening. There it is, and as you can see, it's doing something. And now I'm doing 2 things at the same time, because I have the duty cycle of the third LED set at 0, of the second one at 100, and some maximum value from using this analog input pin. So let's first try and set this back to 0. Let's wait for it. And there we go, to 0. As you can see, now you only have the green LED flashing, because this is 0, that's 0, and that's 100. And on the fly, because we have a connection, we can just change it to, for instance, 400, and you see that it will be on a bit longer. See? Or just switch it off. There it is. And then I, of course, could switch on the other one, the blue LED that was still missing. Or turn on the pot meter again to make the time it is on, the duty cycle, longer, until it's so high that it will stay on. And when I turn it back again, of course, it can be very short, as you see over here. We have a value now of, let's take this one, come on. Well, it's about 1, so it's very, very short. So, now it's gone a little bit more. It's going very fast. So, as you can see, a value of 280 is what you see now. We go back to 0, where it's off again. So, now that's about it for now. So you're able to use some analog input, And for your assignments, you will use another one, and you can do something with PWM that you also need for your assignment. Well, success. Until next time.